Hi, let's solve some questions from BFS and DFS. I already made another playlist for GATE BYQ. Here I will solve some important questions which are not recent or from ISRO. First question, consider a BFS of undirected graph from a node R. Let DRU and DRV represent length of the shortest path from R to U and V respectively. So DRU means distance from R to U, DRV means distance from R to V. If U is visited before V, then what is valid relation between them? So what is valid relation between DRU and DRV? Distance from R to U and distance from R to V. Let's take a graph. Suppose this is our R, this is our U, this is our V, and here some x. It is a undirected graph. There's not many direction. Now we'll do BFS traversal. So let me construct BFS tree for this. From R we'll visit U, then from R we'll visit V, next from U we'll visit x. So distance from R to U is 1, distance from R to V is 1. So it is the shortest path, there is just one edge, so it is 1 and 1. So from this example, we found that D of R U means distance from R to U equals to distance from R to V. Let's take another example and check whether it is always equal or not. Let's take another graph. This is our R, this is U, this is our X, and this is our V. So U should be visited before V. Here you will visit before V. Now we'll do breadth first tree for this. From R we'll visit U, from R we'll visit X, next from U we'll visit V. So now distance of U from R is 1, while distance of V from R is 2. Here we found that distance of RU less than distance of RV. So in one example we found both are equal, in another example we found it is less than. So this will be valid relation. So distance of RU will be less than equals to distance of RV. Let's see another question. Question number 2. G be a graph with n vertex and k component. If a vertex is removed from G, then number of component in resultant graph must lie between, and 4 options are given. Let's take some example. Now this is a graph having 2 component. Here n equals to 7, 4 plus 3, and k equals to 2. Now if we'll remove a vertex, suppose we'll remove this vertex, then number of component, then also there will be 2 component, one component containing 3 vertex and another component also containing 3 vertex. Let's take another example. Let me take a star graph. Now in this star graph there are 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 vertex, and how many component? There is just one component, so k will be 1. If we'll remove one vertex, let me remove this center vertex. So if we remove this vertex, then there will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 component. We are removing this vertex, so that will not include. Now there will be 6 component. So there may be maximum n minus 1 component and lowest can be k minus 1. Now just check the option, answer will be option C. Here we found in case of star graph there will be n minus 1 component if we are removing the center vertex. And you can take some more example and you will find that minimum will be k minus 1, maximum will be n minus 1. In this case we found k component. Previously it was 2, now it also 2. Here previously it was 1, now we found n minus 1 component. So maximum will be n minus 1 and minimum will be k minus 1. Just check the option. In option C, maximum range is n minus 1. In other option, maximum range is different. So answer will be option C. Let's see next question. It was asked in GATE IT 2007. Question number 24. Consider a DFS of DAG. Which of the following is true for all edges UV? And four options are given. Let's take a graph. This is our X, U, and V. This is a directed acyclic graph. Directed and there is no cycle. And there is a edge from U to V. Now we'll do DFS traversal on this. Let me first visit X. So X discovery time will be 1. Then U discovery time will be 2. Then from U we can discover V. So V discovery time will be 3. So we'll finish it. It is a dead end. Here finishing time will be 4. For U finishing time will be 5. For X finishing time will be 6. Now we got a DFS sequence X, U, V. X discovery time is 1. Finishing time is 6. U discovery time is 2. Finishing time is 5. V discovery time is 3 and finishing time is 4. Now just check all the options. Option A, D of U. D of U is 2 and D of V is 3. So 2 less than 3. So there is a possibility that option A might be answer. Next check option B, D of U is 2, F of V. F of V is 4. So 2 is less than 4. So there might be possibility that option B is also answer. Next check option C, F of U less than F of V. F of U is 5 while F of V is 4. 5 is not less than 4, so this is wrong. Next check option D, F of U is 5 while F of V is 4. So 5 is greater than 4, there might be chance that option D is correct. So in one graph, multiple depth first search is possible. Let's do another depth first traversal on this same graph. So first I'll visit X, discovery time will be 1. Next I'll visit V, so discovery time will be 2. After V, no adjacent left. So from V, there is no outgoing S to U. It is a dead end, so we'll finish it. Finishing time will be 3. We'll backtrack, then from X we'll visit U. So here discovery time will be 4. And there is no adjacent left. Its adjacent is U that is already visited. So we'll finish it. Finishing time will be 5. We'll backtrack and we'll finish X. Finishing time will be 6. We did another depth first traversal. It is X, V, U. Now just check all the options. Option A, discover time of U. Discover time of U is 4. Next, discover time of V. Discover time of V is 2. 4 is less than 2. No. So option A is wrong. Next option B, discover time of U is 4. And finishing time of V. Finishing time of V is 3. 4 is less than 3. No. So this is wrong. Option C is already wrong by previous depth first traversal. Next check option D. F of U. F of U is 5 and F of V. F of V is 3. 5 is greater than 3? Yes. So in both the depth first search, we found option D is correct. So answer will be option D. Finishing time of U will be always greater than finishing time of V if there is a directed edge from U to V. Next question, it was asked in GATE IT 2005, question number 14. In a depth first search traversal of a graph with n vertex, and k edges are marked as tree edges, the number of connected component in G is, and four options are given. So it is saying there are n vertex and k edges are marked as tree edges, the number of connected component. Let's take some example. Let's take a graph having two connected component. Now if we'll do depth first traversal, then which edges will include as tree edges? Suppose we'll start from this, then this will be tree edges, this will be tree edges, and this will be tree edges. Now for this component, so these two will be tree edges. Now just count what is n. N equals to 7. 7 vertex are there. And how many tree edges are there? Tree edges are here 3, here 2, 5. So how many components are there? 7 minus 5, there are 2 component. In a tree, there are n minus 1 edges. Let's take another example having one connected component. If we'll do depth first traversal on this, now what will be its tree edges? So this can be tree edges, this can be tree edges, tree edges, tree edges, tree edges. So now how many vertex are there? N will be 6 and K will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 6 minus 5, it will be 1. That is just one component. So answer will be N minus K, option D. If we'll subtract number of tree edges from number of vertex, we'll find number of component. Next question, it was asked in ISRO 2020 question number 32. G is an undirected graph with vertex set, these are the vertex, and edge set, these are the edges. A breadth first search of the graph is performed with V1 as the root node. Which of the following is a tree edges? For solving this question, first you need to construct the graph, then we'll do the breadth first traversal. So from V1 there is a edge to V2, next from V1 there is a edge to V3, next from V1 there will be edge to V4, next there will be edge from V2 to V4, just add an edge, then V2 to V5, we'll create another vertex V5, V2 to V5. Then V3 to V4, just add an edge between V3, V4, then V4 to V5, add an edge from V4 to V5, then V4 to V6, create a vertex V6 and add an edge from V4 to V6, then V5 to V6, already there, just add an edge, then V6 to V7, create a vertex V7 and add an edge. Now graph is constructed, next we'll do breadth first search on this graph and we'll check which edge is present as tree edge. Here it is mentioned a breadth first search of the graph is performed with V1 as the root node. So let me do on same graph, I'll do breadth first search on the same graph and I'll mark the tree edges on red color edges. So from V1 we can visit V2, V3 and V4. V2, V3, V4 are adjacent of V1. So let me add a tree edges from V1 to V2, V3 and V4. Next from V2 we can visit V5. V4 is its adjacent but it is already visited. So from V2 we'll visit V5. Next from V3, V3 adjacent is V4 that is already visited. Next from V4. Before we can visit V6, next from V6 we can visit V7. So this is the tree edges in a breadth first tree. Now just check which edge is present. V2, V4, V2, V4, no this is not present. Next V1, V4, V1, V4 is present. Next V4, V5, V4, V5 is not present. V3, V4, V3, V4 is not present. So answer will be option B. V1, V4 is present as a tree edges in breadth first tree. Next question, it was asked in GATE IT 2006, question number 46. Consider the depth first search of an undirected graph with three vertices P, Q, R given that D of P means discovery time of P equals to 5 unit, discovery time of Q equals to 6 unit, discovery time of R equals to 14 unit, F of P equals to 12 unit, F of Q equals to 10 unit, F of R equals to 18 unit, D for discovery and F for finishing time. Which one of the following statement is true about the graph? And four options are given. According to Corman book, discovery time and finishing time are continuous. But according to some other author, you might see discovery time and finishing time are not continuous. Means after 5, it may be 6, it may be 7, it may be 8. So you need to solve according to sequence. Let me first write down discovery time and finishing time. P discovery time is 5, finishing time is 12, Q discovery time is 6, finishing time is 10, R discovery time is 14 and finishing time is 18. Suppose we will take a stack, first we will push P, then we will push Q as Q discovery time is 6, next we will pop Q as Q finishing time is 10. So we will pop Q, next we will pop P, P finishing time is 12, next we will push R. R discovery time is 14, next we'll finish, we'll pop R. P discover, Q discover, then we finish Q, then finish P, then we discover R and we finish R. So these two are one component and R is other component. Now just check the option. Option A, there is only one connected component. No, there are two connected component. Option B, there are two connected component and P, R are connected. No, P, Q are connected. Option C, there are two connected component and Q, R are connected. Wrong. Option D, there are two connected component and P, Q are connected. This is correct. P, Q are connected. We just found from the discover time and finishing time sequence. I already discussed what is discover time, what is finishing time, and I also discussed some example. There the sequence was continuous, here the sequence is not continuous, but it is in a sequence. You just go through that lecture, you can easily solve this question. So answer will be option D, there are two connected component and P, Q are connected. If this lecture is helpful for you, please like and subscribe. Thank you.